Your cell phone.
So long as it is on, it is transmitting and receiving data.
It is always communicating with the towers. It has to ping back and forth between the towers and device, in order for a call to route to you, a text message to be delivered. It would be impossible for you to have a cell phone and have it work, without continuously giving your location to the cell phone company.
These icons here are each of the cell towers. Typically, a cell tower has what's called three sectors. That's a set of antennas facing in a particular direction. The one lit up in pink here, this is the one that's communicating with the phone. So it's typically the one that's closest to the phone. That signal then gets sent to all of these other towers, and then we measure how long it takes to get to this tower, compare that to how long it takes to get to that tower.
Typically, a cell phone communicates through the closest tower, but the transmission is also picked up by a second tower, usually farther away. The signal arrives at the second tower nanoseconds after the first. Tracking technology plots the points on a map that would create that precise delay. The potential locations fall on a curve.
Between any two towers, a time difference is spelled out by a curve. So with just that single measurement between these two towers, all we were able to tell is that the phone is somewhere on this curve.
Using at least two other towers, they calculate a second and then a third curve. The point at which the three curves intersect is the location of the phone.